Good day and welcome everyone. And today we're going to talk further about the SPM English paper. And don't worry, we are not going to talk about poem again because I put hold for poems because since last few weeks I've been uploading videos about poems and samples of questions. So I'm sure you are tired of it. So today we are going to talk about directed writing, which is very important. Okay. Now before we move, I want to share something with you. Today I was scrolling down my YouTube channel. I found something, actually a video caught my interest. It is a tutorial video. It's about, the title of the video is how to drink water. You can try to search for it yourself. And the most surprising part is that video, that tutorial, how to drink water, got 23,000 likes. And I was like thinking, literally I've been working my ass off here to teach and I'm barely struggling to get likes. But the tutorial on how to drink water, something which is very common that everybody knew, can get up to 23,000 likes. That shows how the world has changed, right? Or maybe I was wondering, maybe that particular 23,000 people don't know how to drink water. But whatever it is, it's their problem, okay? It's their opinion. We are not going to discuss about that. So let's continue with our lesson. As you know, for directed writing, you are given 35 marks. This 35 mark based on 3 different categories. The first one is F, format. For format, you can get 3 marks. CP stands for content points, which you don't have to worry because you will be provided all the points, okay? You can score up to 12 marks for your content points. And finally, language, you can score up to 20 marks. So if you add everything together, you will get total 35 marks. If you're planning to do well in your SPM English paper, please pay attention to all the elements because you need everything in order to score good marks. Okay? And unlike any other languages, in English, we have a very limited set of essays because it's almost as if every year for directed writing is predictable because we don't have a lot of choices. You either will be tested on article, letter, formal or informal, speech or report. These are the only available options, so you don't have to worry. Unlike Malay or any other languages where you have to prepare for a lot of different sets of questions, here you just have to emphasize on these 4. If you can practice on these 4, it is very easy. And since all these 4 are formatted essays, please remember the format because unfortunately, since I am teaching Form 5 students, I still come across few students who are not very clear about the formats, even though the formats we have learned a long time ago since we were in the primary school. So please make sure you know the format and you know how to write the essay. Okay? And while you are doing directed writing, there are a few things that you should keep in mind. Number one, make sure you do the essay within 45 minutes. Why I'm asking you, why I'm giving you time restriction? Because I'm afraid if you use up more than 45 minutes for your directed writing, you won't have enough time to finish up your continuous writing. And as you know, continuous writing, we have to write more and you need to use a lot of time. So please make sure that you use only within 45 minutes to complete your directed writing. Okay? Next, please use all the CP or content points given. Maybe some of the content points are a bit difficult for you to understand, but try to understand and try to incorporate it in your writing, because if you fail to do so, you will be losing points for content points. Okay, so content points are very important, so please try to use all the given content points. Okay, and some question requires you to give your own ideas or own points, so please read the instruction carefully and do your exam. Okay, next, remember power, plan, organize and write. But most of the students, they straight away jump to the third section, which is write. We don't plan, we don't organize, we straight away write. So that is, I'm not saying that is wrong, but it doesn't provide a good composition. We will not be able to produce an excellent composition. So please take a minute or two to plan, organize your points, and then you start writing. And finally, very, very important, please read again your essay once you are done. Because so that if you did any mistakes, okay, you can rectify your grammatical, punctuation or spelling errors. And you also can make some amendments whenever needed. Okay, so please read through your essay once you are done. Next, what are the things that you must avoid? Number one, please do not add own points unless the question asks you to do so. If the question doesn't ask you, if the instruction didn't states that you have to add your own point, please do not give any own points, because no marks provided for your own points. The marks, the content point marks, are only given for the given content points, not for your own points. Even if you give 10 of your own points, we don't even give one mark. Okay? Next, please do not use any exaggeration. I know sometimes you get too excited, so you get carried away. So please do not exaggerate your writing. Please be very precise and vivid. Okay? Next, try to reduce any grammar, spelling or punctuation errors, because most of the time these are the factors which causes you to fail to score in terms of language. And finally, try to avoid informal words, especially SMS style words such as you, are, we, how, are, you. These are informal writing. You are writing in the exam, so please be sure that you don't use these kind of words. I know it's a force of habit, since nowadays everyone of us has smartphone and we have a lot of social messaging applications. So these are the language that we use in our social communication application. So please try not to use this, because sometimes, because force of habit, we tend to use them. If you use any of these kind of writing, definitely you will be losing a lot of marks in terms of your language. Okay, so this video, I just want to give you a brief introduction about directed writing, and I promise the next video we going to go through one by one style of essays, and I'm going to help you how to write a better essay in a better and creative way. Okay, so please stay tuned for more videos, and I hope today's introduction was beneficial. And don't forget to scroll down and search for how to drink water tutorial, and if possible, drop your likes as well there. Okay, contribute to the community as well. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you and see you in the next video.